This is a fact that I'm explaining. And these are the words of the Akhirah, so that we don't regret on the Akhirah. So, a point we have now understood. Yes, a point. What is that? That the real point here is that there's demands from both sides. We need to decide today that we make incorrect decisions. And this is injustice, that with the ruh we do this, and with our bodies we do this. Today we have to promise that when the ruh desires, then we will give full nourishment and resources to the ruh, to our soul and our spirit. Because we know now that the ruh, our spirit and soul, is more in need. Okay, the desires, okay, let's recite the ruh shreef tasbih today. And the ruh, our soul, it says, give to me, and we suppress it, we crush it. Instead of one tasbih, we should recite five tasbih of the ruh, so we can nourish and provide more for the ruh that will benefit us. Whenever the ruh, when we have a desire to do good, it's the ruh says, do good, do good. Sometimes good desires come on, okay, let me recite Quran. And then what happens? Let's come off the line of it. No, my ruh is asking me, let me give it full food. The ruh says, recite half safara, half a juz. Say, no, I'm going to recite two juz. So do this definitely from today, and let's give justice to our ruh. Never suppress and keep the ruh hungry or naked, and keep on providing to the body. So alhamdulillah, when you see that the body, you're giving it all what it needs, more than half a chapati, you give it to naan or above that. No, don't feed it too much, no point. When the ruh desires, and give it the holiday it needs, and the nourishment it needs, and the preservation it needs. Will you do this, brothers? Yes. So this is one point we have to promise today, that we will provide over and above for our ruh. What will give this result? What will be the result of this? The body will feel pain. Oh, you make me tired. You've done five tasbihs, that's enough. And your body will say, I'm sleepy. You start yawning. Just like this dhikr majlis. Did you see this? So various individuals after salah, they ran away, went from the doors, and they said, oh, you'll get tired. What's this? Not farad, this not necessary dhikr. The ruh demanded and was pleading, I want to sit down and eat the fruits of Jannah. Please give me success. I want to get some strength. After many years, I'm old and I'm frail. This majlis come. We've never seen a majlis in Blackburn like this. So many people coming to do the dhikr of Allah. The ruh is screaming, pleading, begging, and we crush it. We ignore it. Oh, go, what a lot of nonsense. Oh, don't speak rubbish. And we listen to the body and we depart. Run away. Have there many people left? Subhanallah. But you have fulfilled the requirement of the ruh. The ruh is giving you du'as now. He's praying for you. He's giving du'as to you. Oh, what a good man, my owner. And subhanallah, then the benefit and the call of the ruh will be going to the heavens. And subhanallah, it will be so beneficial, and it will promise to you that just today you offered and you provide for me and made me happy, then inshallah when you die, I will make you happy. The ruh is saying this, subhanallah, subhanallah. And she stated, radiyallahu anha, kana rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yathkurullah, the remembrance of Allah, yathkurullah, what a very beneficial and short hadith, that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one blessed habit in sunnah, Aisha Sadiqa, who would know more than her, may Allah be pleased with that, his blessed habits, she was the mahbuba of the mahbub of Allah, the beloved of Allah, she said, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sarwar alam, the master of the two worlds, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his blessed mubarak habit was this. And this is very great point she has announced, very essential for us, very, very important message from Ummul Mu'mineen radiallahu anha, that Nabi al-Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ala kulli ayani, every moment, every second, every time, every breath, he used to do one amal, an action. What was that action? Dhikr Allah, subhanallah, subhanallah. And is this a minor hadith? Is it a small message? Is this insignificant? Because the whole deen that we have, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed salah, we pray salah. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept fast, we keep the fast. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam did tawaf, we do tawaf. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam drank zamzam water, we drink zamzam water, isn't it? Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam kissed the Hajarul Aswad, we do the same. All the deen Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given to us, and this is also a part of the deen. Continuous. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha stated that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's glorious practice, a habit, an amal, an ibadah, a worship. What? Every moment, every breath, every second, every time he would do this action. Subhanallah. Every second. In the ratio according to our needs, and we are desperately in need for them. And how desperate are we need? We are very in need. Just like air, if it was to cease, we couldn't breathe. With regards to dhikr, the same applies. The most of all, what does the human being in need of? Dhikr of Allah. Dhikr of Allah. He's in need of it. And who has made us to get this? Shaitan. Because he wants us to leave this world without success. most important, what we are in need of, what item, what action? The dhikr of Allah. Look at this. That's why Allah Ta'ala has made dhikr very common. Salah, 5 times a day. The sample I give you, the greatest sample. I taught you how to eat. He taught you how to go and pass and go to the toilet. He told you how to go to your wife. He gave you libas, attire, how your faces should look. Every single action my Nabi taught you, demonstrate to you in his blessed life. More than 100,000 students of his will have behind. Then they demonstrated to you, and you have brought to me what way of life? Different thousands of different types of actions you brought to me that do not conform to that path. Second point. Let's promise today that every action, every second of our life will be according to who? According to Sunnate Rasulullah. So will we do this, my brothers? I'll keep on asking you for a promise. Inshallah, then we will meet each other in Jannah. Inshallah, this is the theme. This is the lecture. This is the speech. Yes, Bukhari, when you read it, you'll get these words. Ma'iya fi jannati, I'll take you with me. Man ahabba sunnati faman ahabbani. Faman ahabbani kana ma'iya fil jannati. The respected scholars ahead. Whoever loves my sunnah, who has applied surah like me, whoever has done miswak like me, who has slept like me, who has kept his beard like me, all of these, Rasulullah said that the boundaries I gave to you, if you imitated me according to my lifestyle, and you followed it, imitated it, my lifestyle, that the knowledge came to you by the scholars, and you didn't imitate your, follow your desires, Rasulullah said, for man habani, then I love you. Allahu Akbar, imagine. Nabi Sim loves us, and then when I love you, what will happen? Then I will love you in such a way, just like I love Bilal radiallahu anhu, subhanallah. Just like I love Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Have you not seen my love? Siddiq, I loved it. So now we should follow that sunnah. That how did Nabi al-Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam every second do the dhikr of Allah? Because we need to do the same. That's why you're gathered here. Allah's giving you a message today, delivering a message to you today. A communication that not every human being will have come into it, only those will have come who Allah Ta'ala selected. I told you this last time. Subhanallah. And today, I would like to speak to you about this message. Every majlis, the people change. Anything about asking about their deeds or counting, they won't have to wait or stand. No will have to wait for 50,000 years of severity, because Allah Ta'ala said they're ashiks of my remembrance. The ashik, the lover of Allah's remembrance, in his heart is Allah all the time. With enjoyment and doing the dhikr, they will go into Jannah. The people of Jannah, see, you've come so quick. They said, we don't know what's happening on the way. There was no severe trial or test. We entered into paradise very easily, subhanAllah. And this is his blessed sunnah that we are implementing. Number two, we want to attain Allah's nearness, Allah's radha, pleasure. And with the dhikr of Allah, we attain Allah's radha. Number three, we are preparing for our qabr, akhirah, our grave. We want to make all of these phases after death successful. And these are the three reasons we're doing dhikr of Allah. There's nothing else. Nothing extra and over above that. That's it. We don't become wali Allah, sheikh, and do this. These three false desires we need to eliminate. We need to have the three correct desires. And when the heart starts, do this. When the heart starts and it starts to gallop, there's a sign. Let me tell you the sign of the heart that's alive. Let's listen to the sign. The sign will be this, that as soon as the heart becomes jari and the qalb starts to beat, then there'll be a beautiful feeling and emotion in your heart at that time when the heart's alive. You won't be mad or crazy or stupid. An emotion will come into your heart. And what will be that emotion? That you won't, those actions that Allah Ta'ala has told you to refrain from, you'll start to dislike them. And here the clash arises now, isn't it? Yeah, remember what I'm saying. That your emotion and feelings will change. No one's telling you anything. No one's forcing you. But within, because the nur, the light comes. When the light comes, then darkness goes distant. So you will start to feel enjoyment in your salah. Before you used to pray salah in 3, then you'll pray salah 5, 10 minutes. Prostration will become long. And you won't look towards haram, unlawful things. Nobody's stopping you. No one's stopping you, but your emotions will become ajeeb. Okay, let's go beyond this now. That your tongue, it will start to be more silent. People will be speaking. You won't speak wasteful statements. What is this all a sign of? That your heart has become alive at this moment in the dhikr of Allah. With the dhikr of Allah, look at this beautiful point. No one's stopping you. No one's forcing you. Automatically, you'll have the desire to become pious. Allah's prepared automatically for you how to become pious. Allah says, you say my name in your heart, and I will continue to make you pious. So it's such an easy formula. So what do we need to do? Morning and evening.